Good morning, this is Media Red, and today's topic is divide and rule in job and employment. What you are facing in these times depends from country to country and from one city to another.
I'll like to share my experience from life from Norway, 10 till years of write this, and I'm sure that some of you may have been through this already, or that you're into something right now or in the coming future where this would be relevant for you or your children. So stay with us. As everyone knows, and plan for a life or a successful career, you like to have an education and by experience be able to be offered a new job or at least apply, and you apply 10 times, 50 times, maybe 100 times, and 200 and 300 times, both with formal job applications and but also with CV submittals via LinkedIn and other informal contacts. Education is something we focus very much on in this world where you have to be almost specialized nowadays in order to be successful, and while combined studies may ruin quite a bit for you. I can see that for years in US, in Asia, in countries with high population growth, there are terrible issues related to educational qualifications. And then we have career-based offers where you have to be a bit more experienced, or you just need to have the relevant trainee or graduate schemes from your early education. And most consulting and advisories would also demand a master's degree with some relevant courses, but good academic qualifications. Certifications are very popular in the IT industry, and the good part with having being certified with courses is that you can work internationally everywhere and almost anywhere. And then we have typical some issues requiring additional relevant courses that can be software courses, tools, frameworks, models, anything relevant to work, whether you're a doctor or an engineer. Especially in terms of engineering, certifications and courses are quite widespread to this date. Project participation means that a lot of works and tasks and contracts are handled via or with project management. So you'll be more or less in a situation where a project is being rolled out or delivered. That can be organizational changes, that can be software and web and digitalization and software updates where we're going to work more efficient. And not only that, but you're also going to be more independent and improve your skills and spend less time on doing the work a customer or client wants to be done, because most engineering companies, contractors, consulting companies, they work for governments, they work for private sector, etc. So a bit more about how we expect things to happen. Then if a career building is the top down of a pyramid, and character assassination then is the bottom. Let me just explain what I mean by that. The situation you are in right now, or will be in, or have been for 10-20 years is more or less like this. And I'm taking this up in particular with you because I see this being shaped over time, over years, while it was, I know in Norway, for that matter, that in the 90s, people did not have necessarily a bachelor's degree, but they could have some education subjects in some years, and they were awarded a job contract, oil companies, public sector, wherever. But now you'll need degrees, as you know, and that can be anything. And career questioning, I've also been quite much around this. There are quite many recruitment companies, for hire companies, almost everywhere in the world. They're sourcing jobs and candidates here and there. And you'll also need to go through some steps relevant to what you have been doing. And many of us have been had 6-month contracts and 12-month contracts, and probably internships 3 months. And in a consulting and contracting world, you can be sacked or finished anytime. So a useful structure on the CV would be quite relevant, because the municipalities, government agencies, or government companies, they will not give a damn about your qualifications, although you know you have all this in place, or they like you, or you have references and all that, especially in some circumstances. I see now in late 2020 that degrees and formal qualifications as academic scores and grades is being uploaded in these web recruitment portals, what I went through while having a pause in my career during the corona epidemics and so on, it was that when I applied to an I think it was IT advisory, just a simple work, not a directorship or exactly management type of position, they want me to write a user manual or user description over an IT system. asked why should I do that, because I'm a native, I speak and write English, and I speak and write in Norwegian and so on. And she just buzzed away that, oh, don't you want the job? And so I wrote a 4+ pages of user a user guide, in fact, not a user manual. I would say over a two-factor identification solution used by schools in Norway, I think, and yeah, I can just reveal that I did not get the job offer, but okay. Another thing which is happening now with me as well, I mean, I think I have 8 years of formal education, almost 5 years with IT diploma and double specialism, and then I went over to a business school and school of management, and was awarded a master of management, which is also not a typical 1 year degree, but research based, more like MPhil. And why am I telling about my background? Because you should know that okay, he has also postgraduate and qualified for what he's talking about. What I see quite often, or what I have been seeing for the past 10-15 years, is that when I was quite young, in the my mid-20s, IT companies, oil businesses, they were asking, in fact, for relevant experience, and that is, that was so hard to get through. And I see also now if I would like to assume a position as a section head or a leader, etc., they can literally ditch you out by asking for relevant experience. Do you have that? Have you set up catalog structure before in public sector or private sector? I like to, although most of my experience is from private sector, I like sometimes to just put the public sector as an example, because public sector here in Europe and US is that large in scope that although there are not that many businesses and all that companies, at least you have a lot of public sector and government organizations, as you know. And another thing is software. I use a course sheet, which I sometimes add with an application. And the reason I don't have all my courses on a CV is because it's too, there are too many courses, and then you have diplomas, you know, courses where you have diplomas and non-courses where nowadays we can easily learn through YouTube, e-learning, webcast, etc. Thank God that it's much easier to learn now. But that is also like this phase with your discipline and branch and business and experiences, very relevant that you have a course or a work practice with dedicated software. Some may focus quite much on references, and although this is not a typical CV and job application session, I see that there are two kind of recruiters or decision makers, and you may disagree a bit with me, and that's just fine. I know that you have HR and org kind of recruiters are typically females who get up the ladder with handling organizational efforts or constraints, and you have more technical or scientific or subject related recruiters, more like me. So I'm a technocrat basically. Now over to the real deal, and that is some basic rules of Dwyer rule. There, this is actually where I want to lead you towards today. What we experience is that we have in the businesses as well as the work life impediments or just regimes over us telling us what to do and what not to do, and an employer may typically want that they rule, that they are the leaders, they make the rules, contracts, etc. And that we want to determine things, how standards are going to be or how we want to recruit. They, like it is nowadays, public sector or government jobs are not only well paid, that's not my point, but they have a very secure future everywhere in the world. If you get something from the government as a doctor or as an advocate or as a government employee, you're in very safe hands. So that is also a power factor. We take all decisions. Obviously, you're just a servant, as a technocrat, as a engineer, what economist, whatever you are. We control resources. Yeah, absolutely. Resources, not only in terms of work, but I mean, I have politicians and large oil companies, multinational companies, state and government, and regional public sector, municipalities, they receive hundreds of millions per annum for drifting and setting up things. And they control actually institutions. Just check how much universities are spending on things. Just to see how much governments, institutions, ministries, etc., how much they rule, govern, and spend. So obviously, except that some other power factors are related to culture, heritage, religion, country-wise, our country, but also region-wise, having a conflict of interest, your city, my city, municipality level, race and gender. And this is extremely important still today in 2020 and 2021, because in small democracies, you see that like in Norway, they have 70 to 80% females or women employed in the public sector, over a million though. And it's not only an assumption or an assessment or a comment, it is statistically variance, divide between culture, race and gender. It can be 0.1% or 0% foreigners or you know, minorities, 1%, and not even 5% either after you know, 50, 60, 70 years of immigration. So some comments on how things are ruled, led, governed, managed. And then about the dark side of our lives, about the splitting and dividing and tormenting, ruining lives of others, of course. And what all these companies, governments, public sector, whoever they are controlling you, what they do is that they want to split you, as we learned from the theory of divide and rule. They make financial turmoil, like it is in today's you know, systematized or monetized worlds or countries. We have everything digital. We have accounts. You have to formally apply for things, although it's digital now. There are taxes and everything. There are even those billing and invoicing company coming after you. Not only the fact that if the government is offering you benefits for being unemployed or sick or ill or whatever your condition is, they can also misuse the system and take from you. This is quite common, and you'll be familiar with it if you're living in Europe and USA especially, or North America. We make people unemployed. I don't think I would comment that much about being unemployed. You know all about it already. We take from you a confiscation. I mean, small things like a half paid bill or you know, disagreement based issues may lead to the fact that your car or property or something like that is filed on you in formal registers, online Experian and all them, so that you cannot actually apply for mortgage, etc., when you need it. They put pressure on you. Yeah, we put pressure on you. Not exactly on the state level, but everyone around us live in a region, in a state, or in a district, or a region where you have locals controlling you, and they demand from you. Absolutely, it's up to them whether they like you or not, and whether they want to include you or not, or whether you are integrated or not. Lots of fragmentation. You have typically assimilations. These assimilations, you have marginalization. See that some are in the Europe here, fully employed husband, wife, or partners, or cohabitants, or whatever they are, while others are not, and selection, deselection, favor, disfavor, nepotism, quite much nepotism in Europe and other places. Scandinavia, Nordic, small countries have too much nepotism, much like corruption, invisible corruption, unreported corruption. And then we have, we want you to obey, or either you follow our steps and rules, or we'll mock you out or devastate your life. Practical experiences of many of us, and we will make rumors about you. That happens also. You may not be a thief before people chase and chant you away by making false rumors about you. So also a matter of conflicts, issues, not exactly relevant to work. It can be just anything where you're living in. Local things, and we'll put everything you say against you. That is happening. I mean, these two, three rules about rumors and whatever you say, we'll say against you. It's like an old intelligence based technique that everything you do and say and not do will be used against you. So 50 years ago, people were not that advanced in terms of after the World War II, all of the Europe was built up. People were poor, and even Scandinavian Norwegian history is also that. People left to their countries, homelands after the war, and then there were very little public left, 2.9 million, 3 million, 3.5 million, and then they needed not only more natural resources, but a real industrial revolution. So the industrial revolution has been with us for a minimum 100-150 years, but then disrupted by wars, etc. So that is, I think, enough for now. I hope that it has been interesting to listen, and many thanks for watching, and please a comment or subscribe and like. Thank you very much. Looking forward to talk more soon.